Hello guys, welcome to Survival Russia. Today I'm out here in the forest, as you can see. I'm out checking an old logging trail to see if it's possible to get the little Survival Russia vehicle up here. One thing is that one of my campsites are not far from here, but also there's a lot of dead standing dry wood here behind me, and it could be awesome if I could get that back or brought to the homestead. Anyway, this video is not about harvesting wood and so on. The video is gonna be about, as you might already have found out, what's my favorite saw. I think to say my favorite saw is a little bit I'd rather say what is the best saw for me outdoors if I could have only one, because it's a question I get a lot actually. What if I could have only one saw? And yeah, it's a very good question actually. But down there in the backpack in the Swedish LK35, I have that saw with me actually. Here it is. The saw I would choose if I could only have one. It's the Silky Big Boy 2000. It's with 6.5 TPI, as it's called. 6 TPI stands for 6 teeth per inch, but it's not really that accurate. It's actually 6 teeth per 30 millimeters or 3 centimeters. This is a really good, you can say, amount of teeth per 30 millimeters, cuts really really well. But the reason I would choose this is that it's somewhere a little bit in between, what you can say, it's somewhere in between the Big Katana Boy 500 and the Silky Gumboy series, the 340, 270. The blade on this one here is a little bit longer than 36 centimeters, and if a foot is 33 centimeters, then it's like a foot and an inch and a little bit larger. It will be able to do most things a saw should be able to do, and one of the most important things a saw, in my opinion, is supposed to be able to do anyway, is to cut relatively big logs so we can make ourselves a Siberian log fire. And I'm actually gonna make a fire now because I will cook something, because it's a little bit late in the day, and I brought some food with me and whatnot, but that's gonna be for another video. You can see we'll have over there where you can see my orange winter work gloves are. There's a dead standing pine there, it's not very thick or anything. Over here we have another dead standing pine, as you can see, not that small, but the big boy here would be able to take down this pine here very easily without too much trouble anyway. Smaller Silky saw will definitely be able to do it as well, but not as easy as this one. This saw here, the Silky Big Boy 2000, is of course relatively light, much lighter than an axe, and it will do all these wood filling tasks with a lot less calorie expenditure than an axe. This is why I consider the saws really really important for winter survival, or just winter outdoorsmanship basically. The saw is my first choice because it's light and I'm most likely to carry that. But let's cut up some wood and get on with it. Sort of like the top of a pine that have fallen, that have broken off from that stump over there, I guess. So this end here is lodged into the ground, I think. It certainly is. So what this little log here, what is it, about 12 centimeters or something like that. Not too big. Come on. See if it's dry. Feels dry anyway. Starts to bind a little bit. Means we have to undercut. Look at all this fallen pine laying here, and dead standing pine over there, and there's more up there. There's a lot of firewood here, if I can just get it. Can of course divide this little log there, no time with no effort, and that's one of the reasons I would pick this. It can also of course cut smaller saplings and so on if I want to make a shelter frame for my tarp or something like this. I don't believe that much in debris shelters, but that is for a different video and something I have touched up upon earlier. I could take down this pine over there, but I don't want to take it down because I don't want it laying in the snow and all that good stuff. I want to get it a little bit later. But just for fun, we can try and cut this stump here that the piece we just cut off fall off from. This is the piece we just cut is actually the top of this log here. So all this dead standing here. Let's see how it goes. This is not really fair. It's a bit rotten. That was not good. It was rotten in here. Anyway guys, the Silky Big Boy 2000 here is an awesome saw, awesome all-round saw for summer and winter, and especially winter. This is definitely my favorite saw if I could have only one saw. Basically I would be able to cut most of the wood you can see here. It's just a question of time. That'll be very important in the winter. I mean, in my experience, making a good Siberian log fire is much more important than, for example, building a debris shelter or something like this and blah blah blah. The Siberian log fire will keep you warm. I spent the night in minus 10 C's without any shelter, without any sleeping bag or anything like that. I have videos on that. I might link to it, but yeah, I think I'll try and link to it. So the Big Boy here, definitely my favorite saw, but I have many favorite saws because I have quite a few Silky saws. So I have the luxury of being able to pick specific saws. I mean, the Silky Katana Boy 500, for example, that is my absolute most important tool in the winter because it cuts wood really, really fast and big wood, and you can make a really nice log fire and so on. And, but the Katana Boy 500 would be not the best saw for a one saw option, you can say. I think the Big Boy 2000 here fits that bill much, much better. I also get quite a lot of questions about what kind of TPI I prefer, how many teeth per inch or per 30 millimeters do I prefer. For this size of blade here, I'll say that the 6.5 teeth per 30 millimeters is awesome. I would not go less than 8. I have some saws with 10 TPI, meaning 10 teeth per 30 millimeters, but they're not fine by any standards. I mean, you can get saws with 14 TPI, with 24 TPI and so on, but they're there for much finer work for us outdoorsmen and so on and so forth. I'll say not less than 8 TPI, or not more than 8 TPI, rather. I think the Silky Katana Boy has something like, I don't remember, but I think it's 3.5 TPI. And I mean, they are big, big teeth. The 8 TPI, 7.5 TPI, 6.5 TPI, that's all very great. I mean, the Silky F180, I will also try and link to that video up here. It has 7.5 for a very short saw, and it can be a little bit of a problem getting started, but the Silky F180, it has a different handle than these more straight handles. It has a handle that sits more like at an angle, just like the Super XL saws that I will also do a video on, because they are also awesome. But so you have a good pull on the F180, even it has pretty substantial teeth, you can say. So guys, I hope I answered many of your questions. Maybe you have more, I don't know. I'll be happy to answer them. But yeah, the Silky Big Boy 2000, that's definitely my pick of a saw if I could have only one. Now I will get this fire going here and start to cook some food. And that's gonna be for a different video. So guys, please check the links in the description and share and subscribe and bell and like and all that good stuff. And thank you very much for your support. And until next time, get out and train and get it done. And do something awesome. I know you can do it. See you in the next one.